handed them sackloads of food, and they grovelled with base gratitude.
Then, unseen, Joseph cut out around the back and planted a cup in Benjamin's sack.
When the brothers were ready to go,
Joseph turned to them all with a terrible stare and said,
"Stop, you robbers, you little numbers up. One of you has stolen my precious golden cup."
Joseph started searching through his brother's sacks.
Everyone was nervous, no one could relax.
"Who's the thief? Is it Reuben?
No.
Is it Simeon?
No.
Is it Naphtali?
No.
Is it Dan?
No.
Is it Asher?
No.
Is it Issachar?
No.
Is it Levi?
No.
Who's the man? Is it Zebulun?
No.
Is it Gad?
No.
Is it Judah?
No.
Is it him?
Could it be? Could it be?
Could it possibly be Benjamin?
Yes.
Benjamin, this nasty crime has shocked me to my core. Never in my whole career have I encountered this before.
The guards were ordered to seize him and lock him in a cell.
They were also told to throw the key into the Nile as well.
But then, each of the brothers fell to his knees.
"Into the mercy, my king," he prayed, "please."
For he could not have done it.
He must have been framed.
One by one, they offered to take the blame.